please welcome Andreas Faulkner.
Hi, good morning. Welcome in Berlin. OpenStack Cloud is constantly evolving. It's not standing still. As we saw in the video, we are now able to show artificial intelligence on our OpenStack-based cloud. The compute power in the cloud is now available to do such cool things as we just saw. OpenStack is really big. Sometimes it's complex, but it's a very powerful platform that covers all aspects of our cloud. And this is only possible by working in a community, with single engineers providing commits and major companies sponsoring whole modules alike. In many areas, we've just started. For example, we see a strong movement in the integration of container technology. Magnum, Courier, and Zoom are OpenStack's guiding stars for that. They are guiding us to integrate Kubernetes, OpenShift, and co. At Deutsche Telekom, we are committed to contribute our part. We fuel our journey with technology and innovation. We are working closely together with our partners like Huawei and with you, the OpenStack community. At this point, a big thank you. Let's have a look at the time when we started with Open Telecom Cloud. OpenStack was basically infrastructure as a service for us when we launched Open Telecom Cloud in March 2016. But now, PaaS, our neighbor from one floor above, becomes more and more important for cloud business. It is not enough to just install Docker on a Nova VM. We are talking about real integration of Kubernetes and other software into our platform. One example for that is our second-generation Cloud Container Engine. It's a really powerful PaaS service that integrates on OpenStack's technology. Another example, we research securing Kubernetes with Kata containers. That protects your data applications without any need for big changes in your setup. Infrastructure and platform as a service requires also reliable and performant network access. So not only internet access, but also dedicated network access is required to operate a reliable cloud. Here we used our expertise as a telco and developed private link access service. And this combines the experience of a telco with the innovation of OpenStack to offer such a service to the market. But let's set aside all these fancy features and technology for a moment. Being a cloud is one thing, but operate a reliable cloud at a significant size has its own rules. We call this day two operations. Day two operations, this is our expertise at Deutsche Telekom. We provide reliable operational excellence. But honestly speaking, there's still a lot to do in order to sustain our achievements. Imagine, just in 2018, we have tripled the size of our capacity, of our cloud installation. So we still need to understand better what happens in our cloud by better and more sophisticated monitoring tools. This monitoring information needs to go into a trend analysis. For example, we are using Prometheus to monitor our rapidly growing cloud installation. And these findings and this data goes into our capacity management to provide a state-of-the-art cloud experience to our clients. As a result of this research, our customers are able to use a so-called health dashboard. So they are able to have an insight to their cloud services at any time. So we are taking part with our experience as a trusted partner of the community by quality assurance, contribution, and by supporting events like this summit. Reliability, last but not least, also means security. Keeping data private is more important than ever. Think about all the growing number of security incidents and data manipulations. Our customers want to combine the advantage of the public cloud with the certainty of dedicated hardware. This adds an extra layer of security for them. On this stage, we already reported about our plans with the hybrid cloud that is available now. Open Telecom Cloud Hybrid is a fully managed integration of OpenStack on dedicated hardware. If required, it's also available in the customer's data center. Our hybrid solution is a full integration to the Open Telecom Cloud control plane. And as the private and the public part of this solution are based on the same technology stack, we have a great competitive advantage compared to non-OpenStack-based solutions in terms of maintenance costs and operations, reliable operations. This is my favorite one, because we are always compared with the so-called hyperscalers. But together, as the OpenStack community, I say we are a hyperscaler as well. Hence, we are a strong supporter of the so-called Open Cloud Alliance, which enables seamless multi-clouds across operators worldwide. And this works basically just like data roaming in the cloud age. I'm also very happy to announce that we are now part of the OpenStack Passport program as well. So OpenStack does not need to hide. OpenStack is hosting serious worldwide workloads. For example, the Copernicus mission of the European Space Agency collects Earth observation data. This is data about climate, Earth, land, and sea environment. This data belongs to all European citizens and is free for use. However, the amount of data is massive, and that's exactly the challenge. Currently, our Open Telecom Cloud hosts 4 petabytes of Copernicus mission data, and this is growing by about 0.5 petabytes a month. And Open Telecom Cloud has the data and the compute resources next to it, and that's exactly the advantage. This approach makes the data usage a lot more reliable and faster and more efficient for the, for example, for the detection of catastrophes, for applications for insurances and other services that build their business upon Earth observation data. And these fantastic accomplishments are only possible by collaboration, cooperation, reliable operation, and the power of open source. And that's you, the OpenStack community. Thank you very much.